Today I will teach class 7, chapter 6, physical and chemical changes. In day-to-day life, we deal with the different type of changes in our body as well as in nature. As you see, your hair grows, your nail grows, you go taller, as well as your weight increases. In such cases, the changes can be occur simultaneously. So, here the change is defined as any alteration in the substance from its shape, size and state is called change. A change can be reversed or irreversible. As in previous classes, you had already studied about reversible and irreversible changes. In reversible changes, the substance from its initial state can be reversed, but in irreversible changes, a substance from initial state cannot be reversed. But in today's lecture, I will discuss about physical and chemical changes. Here, the classification of changes are number 1, that is physical change, and number 2, that is chemical change. So, in physical change, the change in which change in the physical properties of the substance and the new substance is formed is called physical change. All the physical changes are reversible, which means we get the initial state of the substance. For example, melting of ice. While melting of ice, we get again ice by freezing the water. Rolling of chapati and the crushed can. There are several examples in your book, you can study it, about the physical changes. Number 2, that is chemical change. So, as the name describes the chemical change, the change in which physical as well as chemical properties of the substance has been changed. So, there is the production of new substance take place. So, the chemical changes are irreversible in nature, which means we cannot get the initial state of the substance during a chemical change. So, for example, the chemical changes is rusting of iron, tarnishing of silver, copper articles covered with green layer. Here are the examples which show the chemical change. The few examples are written in the form of chemical reactions. But you have no need to learn these reactions, but you have to understand these reactions. When the iron reacts with oxygen in the presence of moisture, it gave iron oxide, that is called rust. As you see, iron has different color, but due to rusting of iron, it is orange in color. So there is change of iron from one state to another, so that's why it is called chemical change, because the iron form changed to iron oxide, the production of new substance takes place. So this is called chemical change. So we can say that the rusting of iron is a chemical change. The next is the tarnishing of silver. As you see, the silver jewelry gets black after some time. The color black of silver is due to the silver sulfide. This silver sulfide gives the tarnishing of silver. You can write what I said, the names of these substances which are helpful for you to describe these names at the time of exams. So this is called silver sulfide. The tarnishing of silver is due to the attack of silver with hydrogen sulfide in the presence of oxygen, it gives silver sulfide. Next is copper articles covered with green layer. So, sometimes you have seen the copper ring give a green color on your finger. This green color is the formation of copper hydroxide and copper carbonate. So, the green color on the finger or the any other article of copper is due to the attack of water, carbon dioxide and oxygen on the copper, which gave copper hydroxide, copper carbonate. This is green in color. So, here these are the some chemical reactions which bring out the chemical changes. These chemical changes are irreversible, which means we can't go back from this to this, and this to this. So here, the new production of substance takes place. So open your book and see the example here. Here is the activity you can see. I will demonstrate it in the laboratory when we will meet. Here, the magnesium reacts with oxygen to give magnesium oxide. Here, the burning of magnesium ribbon gives the white light, which is the formation of magnesium oxide. So here it is a chemical change. Next activity you can see here a book here in the beaker. The blue color substance is called copper sulfate. When I add iron blade in it, the copper sulfate color changes to green. So this green color is the is due to the formation of new substance that is called iron sulfate. Here, this is a chemical change by the reaction of copper sulfate with iron, which gives the iron sulfate and copper. So, green color gives the formation of iron sulfate due to the addition of iron in the copper sulfate. So, next activity number 6.8 here, the acetic acid, that is vinegar, react with baking soda, that is sodium hydrogen carbonate, which gives carbon dioxide and other substances. This activity can be done at home by yourself. Just take acetic acid, which is easily available. To the acetic acid, add baking soda, few pinches of baking soda. You see the effervescence, the bubbling sound takes place. The bubbling sound or the effervescence is the indication of presence of carbon dioxide. But we can check the presence of carbon dioxide by passing this gas from the lime water. So, lime water turns milky when the carbon dioxide is passed from lime water. So, here is the reaction, that is carbon dioxide reacts with lime water. It gives calcium carbonate and water. So, presence of white or milky white color is due to the formation of calcium carbonate. So, this activity can be done at home by yourself. So, I will attach the PDF file along with this video and you can write the work in classwork as well as homework.